Hey, what's going on, YouTube? iDevice Help here. In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys some of the new things that are available now in Apple's new computer operating system, Mountain Lion. They added a bunch of new features, a bunch of new apps, and I'm going to kind of give you a rundown of what I think and what some of them do, a quick review in a way, and also some tips that you might want to do before you begin using the operating system. For example, you could go ahead and start by going into the system preference and make sure that you add all the accounts that you need to sync all the data to your through the iCloud service. For example, if you have an iPhone, an iPad, or another iOS device, Apple is moving towards making the computer OS more like the iPhone's operating system, so they kind of go hand in hand now. It's more like the same on both platforms. Now you can go here and add your Twitter if you have one, and all your email accounts, and once you add your account, you want to go ahead and enable notes, message, and everything else, calendars. So everything will sync through the cloud wirelessly to the computer, which is really neat. That way you keep all your reminders, your notes, your events, whatever it is that you do on your mobile device will sync automatically to your computer. Kind of like what iCloud does, or iPhoto, that you take a picture on your iPhone and then automatically uploads to PhotoStream, and you can look at your PhotoStream from any iOS device. So that's kind of what it does once you add all those accounts to your Mac. You might want to do that first, and also make sure that your main iCloud account is set up, and now you're pretty much set and ready to go. Now, first application I want to cover as quick is iMessage, which used to be iChat back in the day. I used to make calls. Now, iMessage now implements iMessage from mobile device to computer free. I can go ahead and text myself here quick, and the note appears there rather quickly, as you can see. Or I can reply to myself back, or it shows in any other iOS device. And you can also integrate making a FaceTime call by clicking this button here and selecting the contact you wish to contact. So if I quit the Maps application, and I send, or the message application, excuse me, and I send a text to myself like that, and I'm working on my computer, someone texts me through iCloud, I get a notification here, kind of like I do on an iPhone or an iPad, that you have a notification here on the top, like you would on the device, and you can just go ahead and hit reply, the application will launch, and it's really cool. You can just go ahead and reply right back, type whatever it is that you want to say, and it jumps right back, and it notifies you on your mobile device, just like so, as you can see there. So I think it's really cool that they added all these new features. It's pretty much a free text messaging. You can do it through every iOS device that's connected to iMessage, and you can message your friends and anybody you want that has a Mac or an iOS device. So that's pretty cool. Now, the next application, I think it's iCal, which is pretty much just the same thing as, Calendar. And it's called on Mountain Lion. It used to be called iCal, so now it's Calendar. So whatever calendars you have on any mobile device, everything would just kind of unify and sync together, and you'll have all your events here in Calendar. You don't need to do anything, just as long as you preset all the accounts like I explained at the beginning of the video. Also, reminders and notes. This is really cool. Reminders, you know, if you have a reminder on your iOS device and you're working on your computer and you happen not to have your phone around or your iPad, automatically the computer will remind you as well, just like an iPhone or an iPad would. And notes is pretty much self-explanatory, the same notes application that you get on your mobile device. It's all the notes that you'll get here on the computer itself, and they will sync through the iCloud. So if you add a note on your mobile device, just as long as the account is set up with the computer, then your note would be on your computer as well. I think that is a really cool. There's not a whole lot to do. It's just simple and works. It kind of works, like I said before, the same as a photo. If you take a picture with your iPhone, automatically, if you have PhotoStream turned on your mobile device, it'll automatically add the photo to your PhotoStreams and your photo application. So that's really cool. That's another cool thing. Now, at first I was trying to get the notifications bar to pull out by doing the two-finger scroll like you're supposed to do, like this, but it wasn't working. It turns out you have to put your fingers outside of the trackpad and slide in from the outside. Is that cool? So you go ahead and slide out and back in. So if you do it right on the trackpad, it won't work, so you have to do that. It's kind of weird. Now, here on the notifications, as you can see, if you add your Twitter account, like I showed you there at the beginning, you can go ahead and automatically send a message to Twitter, update your status, and also add your location and all that good stuff. And, yeah, so that's really, really cool. And you also get notifications and, like, native notifications, just like you would on iOS on the computer itself. So I think that was really, really cool. Now, this is a quick rundown, guys. I know I'm going kind of quick, but I just want to give you guys a little a rundown quick of what to expect with this new release. Now, it is going to be costing $20, and it's going to be set to be released at the end of July 2012 here. Now, Safari got an update, a few updates, as a matter of fact. Now, the search bar of Google search bar is also integrated into the URL bar, so you don't longer have two bars. It's only one bar. You can search Google, or you can type a URL. It works for both functions. You also have a cloud to read web pages. If you don't have an internet connection, you can save them. And you can also go ahead and say, I go to a website. Let's go ahead and go to YouTube. And I think this is really, really cool here. If you add this to your reader list, this button here, you can go ahead and add stuff to your reader list. If you go here on your mobile device, whatever it is, iPhone, iPads, and whatever you set on your computer will automatically show up on your mobile device. So I just set up a link to YouTube, so automatically that link to YouTube shows up on my mobile device, and I can go ahead and browse the same website. So it's kind of like a cool way to share links. And also you can save reading list from your device, and it also shows up on your computer, and it's really cool. You can read them offline. Some of them you can read them offline. So that's a reader list. And also the have a Twitter notification or a Twitter a tab, which you can also share websites, pictures, and everything straight from Safari, and also share links through iMessage and email pages. So that's a quick rundown of Safari as well. Lots of nice improvements here in the new operating system by Apple. I really do recommend it. So far, I've been liking it. Of course, you have the mission control and also the launch pad, which gives you a native feel to the iOS platform on your mobile device, where you can just go ahead and search on your Spotlight, kind of like you do on the iPhone. Now you can search as well here on your Mac. So everything is kind of integrating and becoming one, which is it's a good idea in my opinion. I kind of like it that way. That way everything is just there, and I know what I have and how everything works. There's no learning process because you already know everything. Now, there is a few downfalls. There is a few things that don't go, and the update doesn't give you for some Macs. For example, the airplane mirroring for this computer is a 2009. The airplane mirroring is not available for this computer. Because the computer supposedly is too old. I guess there's not enough CPU power to go to use with an Apple TV. But if you do have a Mac computer that's from 2012 or 11 on up, then your airplane mirroring would work. You'll have your option here, and you can mirror the entire display to your TV set as long as you have an Apple TV. Now, I already figured out a way how to enable airplane mirroring on all other Macs, because Apple, of course, is not allowing. But I will have another video showing you how to enable this on your Mac. So I'll have an annotation somewhere around here to that video once I make it available. So you can click that video, and it'll take you to my video on how to enable AirPlay mirroring, and also a video demonstrating how it works and how it looks. So stay tuned for that video as well. And one of my favorite features, and my last feature I'm going to be covering, which is my favorite, is dictation. Now, of course, you guys ask me questions on YouTube, and I do email you guys a lot. I email a lot of people a lot. Dictation is pretty much just dictation like you would have on the iPhone 4S. It's this little microphone here that you get on your iOS device that pretty much just writes whatever you say. You can select a language. They have a few languages here. I'm pretty sure more languages will become available soon. And you can also add a shortcut. In my case, I selected the arrow down to activate the dictation once I'm typing a email or a message. So I can go here into my notes and add a new note and go ahead and try the dictation out. This is a test of dictation on the new Mountain Lion OS. And then you click your shortcut, and there it is, dictation just types. This is really cool, guys, if you are want to make emails or type in emails and you don't feel like writing or want to reply, in my case, reply to some of your questions on Facebook and Twitter and also on my YouTube, then I can use that, and it helps me out a lot. I think that's a really cool feature. Now, like I said, to enable AirPlay, I'll have another video, and make sure you guys stay tuned for that. This is a little quick rundown of some of the new features of Mac OS Mountain Lion. I hope you guys did enjoy this video. Please thumbs up if you did. Like always, make sure you follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and my blog to stay up to date with everything latest on Apple devices. It's been iDevice, and I will catch you guys real soon. Peace.